Hey guys, this is Craig Migliaccio with AC Service Tech, and today what we're going over is how to vacuum a mini split unit down below 500 microns in preparation for adding refrigerant from the bottle or from the service valves. I'm going to show you how we got to this vacuum level during the standing vacuum test because this proves that there is no leaks, there's no water, there's no air, and there's no nitrogen in this system. So this system will be ready for refrigerant. So I'm going to show you all the connection points and preparation and running the vacuum pump. This video is sponsored by our friends at Superior AccuTrack, and I have a link to the videos I made using their ultrasonic leak detector down in the description section below. After connecting your refrigerant tubing from this outdoor unit to the indoor head unit, that's when you pressure test this tubing. So you need to pressure test before you vacuum, and then you vacuum before you add refrigerant into the system. So pressure testing, what you're doing is you're searching for leaks, maybe at the flare joints, and you want to find those leaks before you vacuum because you don't want to vacuum the system. The whole point is that when you're vacuuming, you're trying to remove the moisture, remove the air from the system. So if you have a leak and you connect your vacuum to this port right here and you're pulling a vacuum, it's going to lower in pressure. It's going to turn into a vacuum. It's going to pull all the humidity that's in the air out here. It's going to pull it in through the leak. So you don't want to just vacuum pump without pressure testing. Now I usually pressure test by connecting a valve core removal tool over here. And I like to remove the valve core at this port first before I even pressure test. So first things first, this is a 5/16 port right here. And so this valve core removal tool will fit. This is a 1/4-inch valve core removal tool, so this will not work in this situation right here. Now remember that we don't actually have to connect this right now because this is empty tubing. If this did have refrigerant in it and we wanted to replace the valve core, then we would need the entire component right here. But all we need right now is just the back. So we're going to take the back and we're going to pull the valve core out. Since this is empty. So there's the valve core. What we're going to do is we're going to connect this valve core removal tool. And what I like to do when I'm pressure testing is I would just put this valve core removal tool in place and I connect a quick connect test gauge right onto this port. So then I'll connect my refrigerant hoses right to here. And so I'll add the nitrogen in, then I can shut it off. Then I can read my pressure over say a 10-20 minute period to see if it's going to fall or not. So after that's done, that's when I'm hooking the vacuum setup up. So to hook the vacuum setup up, I like to use a second valve core removal tool. And the reason for that is so that I can isolate my vacuum gauge. So I hook this other valve core removal tool right up to this port, and I make sure that there is no Schrader valve in the port of my valve core removal tool. Then I connect my vacuum gauge right onto this second valve core removal tool, and the reason for that is just so I can shut it off as I break the vacuum with refrigerant from the bottle or from the system, and that refrigerant and oil will not contaminate the vacuum sensor in here. So I can read a vacuum by having this open, and while the vacuum pump's running, I'll be able to read the vacuum, and then I can shut this valve off and I'll read the vacuum that's actually in the system with the vacuum pump off. So that's why I like to use this setup. Make sure that you don't put the valve core back into the port again until after you have positive pressure in this system from the refrigerant. So you're not putting this in until you're just about all done. So if you tried to put this back in before you have positive pressure in here from the refrigerant, you're going to accidentally lose part of your vacuum. Now the reason that we're removing this valve core in the first place is to make sure that we're removing the restriction so that we can have a deeper and faster vacuum. This is a 4CFM vacuum pump, and just so you know, all the tools used in this video are linked down in the description section below. So we're going to leave these two caps on, and we're going to just remove this top cap. We're going to install a 3/8 hose. So this is a 3/8 vacuum hose with a 3/8 end, and this side has 3/8 to 1/4 inch. Now you could use a standard 1/4 inch hose. You could use a 3/8 hose that has 2 1/4 inch connections, and we can connect here and right over to here. But this is what we're using today. So we're going to go ahead and connect right onto this end of the valve core removal tool. And we want to make sure that all of our other connections are snug before we start our vacuum pump. So that's snug. This is snug. So everything should be ready. And then we can go ahead and turn our vacuum pump on as soon as we turn our vacuum gauge on. So I'm just waiting for this to start up. And what it'll do is it'll end up reading the micron level. And you can change it just by pressing the units value right here. So we're going to turn our vacuum pump on now. Very soon you're going to see it reading the micron level. Now as this is pulling down, what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn these valves off and then on again once we get down to maybe 700 or 500 microns. And the reason for that is there's a little bit of air trapped on the ball valve on the inside of these tools. So I'll just go ahead and I just close them just once and reopen them right away. So we're pulling down below 500 microns. I like to target around 200 microns or maybe 150 microns. And you could do a triple evacuation if you needed to, but we're going to prove that we are able to hold the correct vacuum level with just a single evacuation. So I'm just going to close this again. So now I've turned the vacuum pump off and we're reading the true vacuum level inside the tubing here. Now the reason that the micron level is going up is because we have coming from here is where we're pulling the vacuum, but we're pulling the vacuum through the indoor head unit and all the way over to here. So right now our vacuum is equalizing between this side and this side. I just want to time this, and so you know, during the standing vacuum test, this vacuum gauge could go off because the vacuum gauge is only going to stay on for, say, 10, 15 minutes, and then it's going to shut off just to save battery life. So I'm just going to let this timer run, and we'll see how much this vacuum, this true vacuum level rises. So you see that we're at 10 minutes, so I'm just going to go ahead and stop this. And you see that our vacuum had to equalize first, and then once the vacuum was the same on both sides, the vacuum level hasn't risen. So that means that we are good and we're ready for refrigerant. So what I'm going to do next is get our refrigerant bottle and hose ready so that we can add refrigerant into this port right here. Now normally all we would need to do is just go ahead and get ready to open these valves right here. So what I typically do is I valve off my vacuum gauge so I don't get refrigerant oil into the sensor in there, but basically you could just take your Allen wrench and then open this up counterclockwise in order to allow the refrigerant from this outdoor unit into here. But in the case where you have extra line set added past the maximum amount that the unit has refrigerant for, so for instance, it'll say the minimum and maximum line set lengths. And so if you're above the maximum line set length, what they say to do, you're gonna have to add refrigerant into the system. So say we had to add 10 foot of refrigerant. So that's a 10 foot for the liquid line and 10 foot for the vapor line. So right here you see that we have R410A and quarter inch. What we have is 0.2. So 0.2 times an extra 10 foot, that would be 2 ounces of R410A refrigerant. And down here you see the vapor line size of 3/8, and that is 0.024. So this right here is 0.24 ounces. So 2.24 ounces is how much we have to add to this system. So this chart is actually found in our Refrigerant Charging and Service Procedures for Air Conditioning book. So that's our book right there. You can check that out over at our website. So first thing here, we're going to end up taking this refrigerant bottle. And you want to make sure that you have a valve on the end. And I don't have a valve core depressor in the end of this hose. So our valve is off. Our bottle's in the upside down position because we want to make sure that only liquid comes out of this tank, because it's a 50-50 mix of two different refrigerants. So it will come out of the bottle as a correct mix if it comes out as a liquid. So now that we have that, we're ready with that. We can go ahead and get ready to zero a scale. But now we're going to get the air out of this hose right here. So we're just going to open this up slightly to get the air out. We don't want to put air in our system. Okay, so now we have just our liquid refrigerant coming through here. And what we're going to do is we're going to attach right here onto the end of this valve core removal tool. Now, while this valve is in the off position, we're going to go ahead and disconnect our vacuum hose. And we're going to take our hose here, we're going to connect it in. Now we want to purge the air out right here, so we'll go ahead and open this up. Now that we have refrigerant all the way over to this hose, we want to go ahead and turn the scale on. So you see the scale is zeroed out, and now we're going to go ahead and turn this off, and we're going to open this up. So there we have our 2.3 ounces of refrigerant, and so now we're good. At this point, we can go ahead and disconnect right here. So we turn our valve to the off position, and then we're going to take our hose off. And then after that, we can go ahead and open these valves up counterclockwise. At that point, we would just go ahead and put our valve core back in, and then we're going to leak check our valve core, and then we're good to go, and we can go ahead and start the unit up. So I'm just going to shut this off. Take our valve core, we're going to put that back in, and we're going to open this up, and we're going to purge a small amount of air right here. And then we're going to screw this back in. So now that there's pressure in there, you need to push forward as you screw this in. Now we want to go ahead and just leak check this before we just take this off over here. So we turn this valve to the off position. And then we want to see to make sure that this valve core is resealed back in here and it's holding the pressure back. Now we can test it with bubble leak detector. So you can either apply bubble leak detector right in the end, and sometimes you'll have a large glob and it'll fall out, or you could take a cap and drill a little hole in the end. So this is like a little tester that I use. And then you want to see if it's going to blow any bubbles out. If it doesn't blow any bubbles out, then we're good. And we can go ahead and just disconnect right here. So you want to wait for maybe 1 to 2 minutes. Just make sure that you don't have any bubbles being blown. And there is no bubbles. So now we're going to go ahead and just disconnect this. So then you're going to put your Allen key in. And you're going to turn that counterclockwise almost all the way back. And this one too. You're going to turn it. So once it starts getting snug, you're going to stop on both of these, and then you can go ahead and put the caps back on here, here, and then also one on your valve core, and then you can go ahead and turn the system on. And make sure to check out our refrigerant charting and service procedures for air conditioning paperback and ebook, both available at our website at acservicetech.com. We also have the paperback available over at amazon.com. If you want to help support this HVACR training channel, click here. If you want to subscribe, click here. And if you want to see another HVACR training video, click right here. Hope you enjoyed yourself, and we'll see you next time at AEC Service Tech Channel.